As of June 25th, 2023, there are currently 42 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is the Santa Maria volcano in Guatemala, which has been continuously erupting since 1922. A 1902 Ultraplanean VEI-6 explosive eruption destroyed the southwest section of the volcano, forming a large scarp, but in its aftermath, a lava dome complex to the southwest has grown on its edge, known as Santiaguito, ever since 1922. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Alaska, an intense earthquake storm occurred at the Takawangha volcano, while signs of ground deformation were finally confirmed at the Trident volcano, both of which are currently an alert level of yellow. Meanwhile, in Hawaii, the Kilauea volcano somewhat abruptly ceased erupting, seemingly ending a 13-day-long eruption. And in Peru, seismic activity has been increasing underneath the Ubinas volcano for the past 5 weeks. This reached such a high level that on June 20th, 2023, the volcano's alert level was raised from green to yellow, marking the first time it was at a raised alert level since April 5th, 2021. These elevated rates of earthquakes were believed to be caused by the influx of a new batch of magma into Ubinas' underlying magma chamber at a depth of 8 to 15 kilometers. This raised alert level was then proven as being warranted, as on June 22, 2023, at 11 minutes past midnight, a series of ash emissions were produced by the volcano. A new eruption had begun, Ubinas' first since 2019. This eruption was either phreatic or volcanian in nature, and sent a plume of ash a kilometer above the already impressive 5,672-meter or 18,609-foot-tall stratovolcano. More explosions occurred the following day at around 9:20 a.m. local time, once again creating a moderately sized ash plume. Previous eruptions of this volcano have lasted anywhere from less than a week to a little more than 3 years in length, largely consisting of intermittent explosions that eject ash that mostly falls within a 20-kilometer radius. Almost all of these eruptions are rated as either a 2 or a 3 on the Volcanic Explosivity Index, so it is quite likely that the current eruption will match this description. In Hawaii, the Kilauea volcano ended its 13-day-long effusive eruption on June 19th. In much of the last week, eruptive activity had primarily occurred through a single spatter cone on a section of its south-southwestern caldera wall. This spatter cone repeatedly partially collapsed and then rebuilt itself. However, at 4 p.m. local time on June 19th, this vent's intensity quickly waned before stopping altogether. Now, no lava is currently visible, and seismic activity along with sulfur dioxide emissions have greatly decreased. However, it appears that once again, magma is intruding into Kilauea's underlying magma chamber, as shown by the upward ground deformation which has been ongoing at a low rate ever since the eruption ceased. Thus, while Kilauea could erupt again at some point in the next few weeks, for now it appears that its eruption has truly paused and could be a while before it erupts again. In Alaska, the Trident volcano has intermittently been at a raised alert level of yellow ever since August of 2022, when increased seismic activity that I presumed represented an intrusion of magma occurred. I interpret this intrusion to have eventually created a sill which moved in two directions, one towards the Katmai volcano which quickly solidified, and one towards the Majic and Martian volcanoes which is still producing earthquakes. Well, we finally got some form of confirmation that magma is moving at least underneath the Trident volcano, as it was confirmed to have produced 2 inches or 5 centimeters of uplift in the last 12 months. Elsewhere in Alaska, in the Aleutian Island chain, on an unpopulated island, a new earthquake storm occurred at the Takawangha volcano. This volcano, along with the neighboring Tanaga volcano, was the site of hundreds of closely spaced shallow earthquakes during the first 2 weeks of March 2023, seemingly indicating a shallow magmatic intrusion underneath Tanaga's Sajaka 2 cone. Yet, this did not end up resulting in an eruption. Earthquake activity at the two volcanoes had been declining ever since then until a cluster of 20 volcano tectonic earthquakes occurred on Takawangha's southwestern flank on June 22nd. The following day, 40 earthquakes occurred. This seemingly suggests increasing pressure in its hydrothermal system, which, although highly unlikely, in my opinion at the present, could theoretically trigger a phreatic eruption. Here is a list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on June 24th of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.